gentlemen, please help me welcome the parents of the groom, Michael and Kimberly McGlathery. Please, a very warm welcome for the parents of the bride, Edward and Joanne Dougherty. And here is your wedding party. Give it up for Amy Grasso, escorted by Andrew McGlathery. Put your hands together for Lindsay Edwards, escorted by Alex Haig. A warm welcome for Gabby Indelini, escorted by Dylan Haig. Alright, give it up for your maid of honor and the brother of the groom, Julie Dougherty, escorted by Brandon McGlathery. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my distinct pleasure to introduce for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Ryan McGlathery.
Lost beneath the lights, I felt small under the galaxies. It was one of those familiar nights, I felt big with you next to me. Oh my, I think that I am land for kings. You are gold.
Give it up for the McLatheries. All right. Caitlin, my dear, if you and your father would like to take the center of the dance floor.
May you have auspiciousness and causes of success. May you have the confidence to always do your best. May you take no effort in your being generous. Sharing what you can, nothing more, nothing less. May you know the meaning of the word happiness. May you always lead from the beating in your chest. May you be treated like an esteemed guest. May you get to rest, may you catch your breath. May the best of your todays be the worst of your tomorrows.
A big round of applause for Caitlin and her dad. All right, Ryan, feel free to escort your mother to the center of the dance floor. A nice big round of applause for Ryan and his mom.
Hello, everybody. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Andrew. I'm Ryan's youngest brother. He has asked me to share a few kind words about him tonight, and to which I quickly agreed, for there are more than a few that I could share. Ryan, sometimes it is easy for me to forget that you are 5 years older than me because we've gotten so close. Growing up, I wouldn't say we were particularly close as kids, although you were by and far one of my largest role models. I attribute part of my success in high school to you because I always looked up to you and seeing you as a good student who got good grades, I wanted to be just like you.
Well, thanks.
A lot of my interests and taste in music, hobbies, and sports knowledge came directly from you. In fact, I feel like a lot of my sports knowledge and opinions still come directly from you. Since then, we've grown to be a lot closer. Once I graduated high school and went off to college, you and Brandon quickly became two of my closest friends. And whenever I had something on my heart and mind, I could come to you and you always had a sound, calm response. And throughout my entire college career, you're always just one quick text message away, for which I was very grateful and am still very grateful. Being now that I live in Chicago, it's kind of hard sometimes because I miss hanging out with you and Caitlin. Caitlin, I am glad that you can put up with Ryan's ridiculous sense of humor and his nerdy interests, but I am very confident that you two are going to make a great team, and I am excited to see what the future has in store for the two of you. So, to Ryan and Caitlin.
Okay, I had to write my speech down. For those of you who don't know, I'm Julie. I'm Kate's younger sister. I imagine there were times when it was annoying having me as a younger sister. I was always tagging along to everything you did with your friends. I was stealing your clothes. I was stealing all of the mixed CDs that everybody was giving you all the time. We definitely had our screaming matches, but far more frequently, we were in tears from laughing. But all those years, sharing a bedroom, sharing a car, and sharing a childhood, made you not just my big sister, but my best friend. Ryan and I didn't get off to the best of starts. We met during an election year. But the more time I spent with him, and the more time that I spent with them as a couple, I could tell that they were absolutely perfect for each other. Ryan is the kind of person that will always, always come through for his friends, and I have no doubt that he'll be everything Kate needs in a husband. So Kate, growing up with you has been a lot of things, but mostly it's been fun. And if there's one thing I hope you have in your marriage with Ryan, I hope you guys have a lot of fun. To Kate and Ryan.
Thank you. I love you.
And then who's doing the blessing?
Can you sort of announce it?
Oh, yes.
Absolutely. All right, ladies and gentlemen, please bow your heads for the blessing.
Lord, creator of heaven and earth, we offer thanks today for your goodness, for the wealth of family and friends who join us this evening, and for the abundance of love and laughter we are sharing. We pray that you bless Katie and Ryan's marriage and give them the grace to help their love grow and flourish. Most importantly, we give thanks for the meal we are about to share. We ask your blessings on all who prepared it and will serve it, and on all who are about to enjoy it. We thank you in the name of Jesus, your Son. Amen.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, that does it for the formalities. Kick back, relax. You can loosen the ties, kick the shoes off. Let's have some fun tonight.